नमस्कार। होप ब्रेन के इस चर्चित कार्यक्रम जो बिल्कुल एक प्रकार का सेक्शन है कल्चर मैटर्स विद कैलाश में आप सभी का स्वागत है। आज इंडियन म्यूजियम कोलकाता की डॉक्टर नीता सेन गुप्ता है। नीता सेन गुप्ता बताएंगी कि ये जो हैंड फेंस है उसकी यात्रा क्या है, उसकी ब्यूटी क्या है, उसका एस्थेटिक्स क्या है, उसकी एस्थेटिकल सेंसिबिलिटी क्या है, उसकी जर्नी क्या है, और कलकत्ता के जो इंडियन म्यूजियम में उसका कलेक्शन है उस कलेक्शन पे वो बात करेगी। तो मैं बिना समय गवाए नीतिशन गुप्ता को लेता हूँ। नमस्कार, आपका स्वागत है फोक ब्रेन के इस पटल पे। यू आर मोस्ट वेलकम मैडम। It is a matter of great pride for all of us that you have accepted our proposal to present your lecture demonstration on hand fans, beauty in utility, how the folk see the elements of beauty in Indian culture, and that is depicted. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? आप मुझे सुन पा रही हैं?
हाँ जी जी
हाँ so
जी
I will tell you to start your presentation, and in between I will keep telling people about you. So first you talk about yourself, about the theme, and when you need to present the PowerPoint presentation, I will bring the presentation in front of you, and you can start doing this. Please start your presentation.
Okay. नमस्कार, आई एम नीता सेन गुप्ता फ्रॉम इंडियन म्यूजियम। आई एम वर्किंग इन इंडियन म्यूजियम फ्रॉम लास्ट 30 इयर्स। टुडे आई वुड लाइक टू present a paper on hand fan and users, beauty and utility. पहले मैं डॉक्टर कैलाश कुमार मिश्रा जी को धन्यवाद ज्ञापन करना चाहती हूँ, because he has given me an opportunity to present this paper. नमस्कार कैलाश जी, दिस इज एन अटेम्प्ट टू ब्रिंग द स्टाइल ऑफ हैंड फैंस एंड ब्यूटी, एंड टुडे वी वुड लाइक टू एक्सप्लोर हु आर द यूजर्स। द एम ऑफ दिस प्रेजेंटेशन इज टू सर्च ए कॉन्साइज ओवरव्यू of the role of hand fans and users not only in the daily life but also in socio-economical scenario. In 1857, India received the first electricity connection for houses, and the first mechanical ceiling fans appeared in the early 1860s and 70s in the United States, and a steam of running water was used to run the fan. But in 1882, electrically powered ceiling fan was invented, but it was used for the room of higher officials and aristocrat family. What about the middle class and the general public? We know India is a tropical climate based country, and most of the time the humidity is more. It raised up to 80 to 95%. Therefore, only hand fan can be used to get relief from heat and sweat. As per literary sources, in 5th century Christian era, we can find a reference of hand fan in drama of Kalidas, Abhigyan Shakuntalam, where he elegantly described about the uses of hand fan. Both Anushwa and Priyambada are fanning their friend Shakuntala with the help of a lotus leaf to provide comfort from heat of summer. And Anushwa and Priyambada are also asking, "Do you feel better, dear, when we fan you with these lotus leaves?" Third chapter of Abhigyan Shakuntala. Another.
Next slide.
Another reference we are getting. In the Ramayana, this is a Pahari painting where we can find that Ramayana, scenes from Ramayana where Sita is fanning Ramachandra with the help of lotus leaves. In her left hand, the lotus leaf is, she is holding a lotus leaf. There are mainly Sita is fanning for the comfort of Ramachandra and to provide relief from heat. Therefore, it is clearly shows that uses of hand fan are very old tradition. There are mainly four types of hand fans: rigid, folded, revolving, and sealing. And various type of materials are also used to prepare the fans: palm leaves, scientific name is borosus, is also available in the Asia and Africa. These leaves are mainly used for preparation of fans and mat, etc. Beside these, ivory, fabric, cotton and silk, khashkhash, paper, bamboo, peacock feather, etc. are used for preparing hand fan. There are various type of fans: interwinged, painted, embroidered, and these fans are decorated with beautiful frills. During summer season, handmade fan is mainly prepared to palm leaf and largely used in the eastern India. It is very much useful for the ladies of every family to avoid the heat and sweat. A broad flat surface and attached with a bamboo handle
that is waved back and forth to create an airflow which gives comfort from sweat and heat. Normally on human skin, the airflow from a hand fan increases evaporation, which creates a cooling effect due to dormant heat of evaporation of water. Hand fans are most convenient to carry around, especially folding fans. Usually, stiff handle fans are shaped like a circular and made of a thin material like palm leaf, ivory, sandalwood, paper, and feathers. Mounted on slots which revolve around a turn down to so that it can be closed when it is not used and easily placed inside the handbag. Usually, ladies are kept a folded fan in their handbag to get relief from heat and sweat. Even these days, when electricity is easily available, each and every corner of the village, hand fan is using. Still using, and it is very functional and useful. Not only for the lower income group, but also in between the aristocratic ladies. During 18th and 19th century, in Bengal, there were several rituals where hand fan was very much essential. During the month of Jaisth, a popular ceremony is Jamai Shoshti, where elder female member of the family, especially mother, taken a new palm leaf hand fan and 21 pieces of durba or dhup grass, ripe mango, 21 bamboo leaves, banana flowers, new threads, etc., placed on it, and then with the help of this hand fan, she took bath and performed a ritual and then sprinkled water from the hand fan on the head of her children along with son-in-law for their safety, and then offered new dresses and food to them. Another scenario is very popular in the early Bengal period in novel and cinema, where mother, wife or grandmother or mother-in-laws are fanning with a hand fan to provide the comfort to the husband, son-in-law, sons, or any guest or any family member who are taking food or meal for in the summer season. In the village, there is a tradition where every year in the month of Boishakh Joshto, means April, May and June, they used to cut palm leaves, and after drying the leaves, they prepared handmade fan for each and every member of the house. From the month of April, fan seller can easily see in the village area. There are two types of palm leaves fan: rigid and means fixed handle, and circular fan, handle fan. Rigid fan is used for personal use only, but the circular fan is used to offer comfort for more persons.
Doctor Sen, yes, please keep showing your Please keep showing your PPT also. Keep showing your PPT also. PPT, you are not showing. Just one PPT is there. So or other slide also you can keep showing. No?
Please show other. I will show the presentation later on.
Okay. Please carry.
I will start presentation.
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
In Bengal, the aristocrat family, they have their fixed person for fanning. They kept servants who fanned them, and usually they were used large size palm leaf fans with long handle or cloth fan to provide more air and prevent the heat. These large handle palm leaf fans are mostly used to provide comfort to the master of and aristocrat by the servants. In Bengal, it is believed that every year during Durga Puja or Devi Paksha, Devi Durga comes to her parental house as a daughter for 10 days. Even these days, all traditional Jamindar families, when offered food or bhog to the idol, to large handle palm leaf fans are used to provide comfort from heat of the idol. There are another type of fan, that is ceiling fan, made of cloth, and it was used for fanning the whole room, and there is a man who with the help of cord or thread constantly fanning. These fans are very popular in the 18th-19th century Christianity. Now we will go to see the who are the users. Here we can see that a devotee with the help of long handle palm leaf, he is fanning to Nathadwara Krishna. This is from a painting, miniature painting from Rajasthan. This is a Bikaner painting where we can see the Naika is in a relaxation mood and fanning herself to avoid the heat and sweat. Next. This is also a rigid fan with a cloth embroidered where here king is enjoying music and a person is holding a long handle fan and fanning this king. This is a Kangra painting. Jogumaya is watching evening dance of Shiva, and this lady is with the help of round fan cloth made of cloth is fanning the Jogumaya. This is also from Pahari School of Painting. This is Naika is waiting for and anxiously waiting for her lover, and she is also holding a rigid fan. This couple is enjoying rain clouds, and this lady is holding a fan who was fanning them, but at present she also watching the rain clouds. This is a Dutch Bengal school oil painting. This painting shows, this is shows Rama's coronation, and here this person holding a fan with a cloth frill, fanning them. This is Murshidabad late Mughal period's painting. Here they are enjoying Diwali, but this lady holding an ivory fan, rigid ivory fan. This is also from Murshidabad painting. This lady is sitting, she is off mood and holding a rigid fan. This is also late Mughal painting from Murshidabad. Here prince enjoying the moonlit night, lovers on terrace, this lady fanning them with the help of a long handle fan. This is a Madhubani painting where we can find a gorgeous fan, hand fan with long handle. He is holding this fan. This person is holding this long handle fan, and she is seated, and she offered lots of plates with foods and sweets. She is fanning with a small embroidered gorgeous fan. This is from Orissa. This is a bone object, Gopal, Naru Gopal. Here we can find, in the base we can find a hand fan, a lady with a long handle hand fan fanning Muralidhar Krishna. This is also Kaliya Daman on bone. Here we can find this bone carving. We can find a small handle fan. This lady is fanning her. Here also Chamur. She is fanning with Chamur and she is fanning with a hand fan. This is early Bengal painting where we can find a bamboo palm leaf interwined hand fan, rigid hand fan. This is ivory Durga from Murshidabad, where we can, in Chalchitro, we called it, so the backdrop is called Chalchitro, where we can find this person holding a fan and fanning Shiva. Shiva seated here and Nandi also resting here. Shiva holding and Tanpura, and this person holding a fan and fan, he is fanning Lord Shiva. This is a Baluchori Shari, where in the Anchal we can see that a long hand fan. This person, this is a king, you know, who is going on horseback in the forest, and with the help of a long handle fan, this person is fanning him. This is a painting of Abanindranath Tagore, and this painting title done by Abanindranath Tagore himself. This is Samat. Here this couple seated with on a charpai in the open air courtyard, where this lady is holding a fan, embroidered hand fan. This fan from the collection of Indian Museum, and it is purchased in 1905 from Sylhet, Bangladesh, and for rupees 48. This is also an hand fan interwined ivory hand pan. This is purchased Deputy Commissioners of Sylhet for rupees 48 in 1905. Same type of two fans we have. This is revolving fan. This handle can revolve. It is circulate continuously and gives air to 380 circle. Bamboo interwinged. This is interwinged bamboo handle. Previous one. Hand fan from Assam. It is 1886. It is collected from Calcutta International Exhibition. Next. This is also a beautiful rigid hand fan intertwined, and it is made of bamboo strips. You can see the handle, beautifully prepared this handle. And it is only used for personal use. It is presented by Assistant Curator of Economy Museum in 1901. These fan prepared from Borassus flavifer from Tanjore, Madras. Because I'm telling Madras, at that time it was Madras Presidency, and it was purchased for 8 anars in 1886 from Kolkata International Exhibition. It is also prepared that Borassus palm leaf and painted. This is handle made by wood. This part is wood. They fixed with this palm leaf, and it is lacquer polished, painted lacquer polished. It is also purchased from Kolkata International Exhibition 1896 for 8 anas. This is same type of fan. Palm leaf fan, painted palm leaf fan. This is very beautiful fan. Its price was 1 rupee. It is from Madras Presidency, means Madras, and now we know Madras become Chennai, and it is also purchased from Bengal Art International Exhibition. This is that is previous one. This is reverse, and next is upwards. We can see the both side painting is different. Here is a peacock feather. This is floral design. This palm leaf is very interesting. The handle is wooden handle with a gold polished, and this area is beautifully design, and they just take a palm leaf and remove the in between part, leaf part. They wing part, means vein part, they kept, and they put their mica sheet, and on mica sheet they painted with help of white color, and it is beautifully, and this gold polished also we can find clearly. This is beautifully, but the frills become damaged. The silk frills become damaged due to age. This is also purchased for rupees 7, and it is registered as a talc fan. Talc from Tanjore, Madras. It is also from International Exhibition, Kolkata, 1886. I want to show you that this part, this border part, they both, this is obverse and this is reverse. Here we can see the floral designs. Floral designs they have prepared made, but here is a geometrical designs. It is not that jali designs, geometrical jali designs they have prepared, and these micas, they put the micas. You can easily identify them with the glaze and with wooden handle. Next. This is also a beautiful fan of made of khoshkhosh, and it is painted, and this is wood, this handle made by wood, and this part become damaged. This is beautiful khoshkhosh fan. It is purchased also purchased from Kolkata International Exhibition in 1886 for rupees 4 anas. This is a simple palm leaf fan with long handles. This is, we know, palm leaf handle, leaves handle like this, and it was painted here. And these net designs you can find, they beautifully prepared, and they cut this portion and fixed here mica sheet. How much time they have spent to prepare a fan? Beautifully they placed mica sheet here, and then also you can find these net designs, and in the middle part they have painted with red color. Now it become orange due to age. These leaves from Goa, this palm leaf paka from Goa, Bihar, and it was purchased in 1869 for rupees 1. This is from beetle winged embroidered fan made by Mahadev Bhavani Jaigar. It was purchased for rupees 25 from Sawadwari, Mumbai, Bombay. It was at that time Bombay Presidency. I keep this as it is because it gives ideas to us that how much area Bombay Presidency was. The Sawadwari, Bombay, in 1886, the silk frill was damaged, now ravaged due to age, but this area beautifully painted wooden handle, and this area made of palm leaf and embroidered cloth. This is jari work. Jari embroidered cloth, silk cloth, and embroidered with beetle wing. This is commission. There was a manufacturer in Kolkata, Bhavanipur. It was acquired in 1889. This is ivory interwined fan, and profusely used with a gold thread. This is gold thread, designed with gold thread, and in the frill also we can see the gold and silver thread, and the handle is beautiful handle made of ivory. This is obverse. I would like to show you reverse. The design is different. From offers, reverse design is different. See that this is a diamond-shaped design. Next. This is from presented by a monk named Yude Winda from Monastery of Rangoon, Myanmar, in 1983. It is inscribed hand fan. made of paper. These fans are from the collection of IGRMS Bhopal. I went there. I have seen this fan there on display. This is made of cloth and paper and cloth and beautifully multicolored textiles they have used. Fabric they have used well. This is also embroidered hand fan with wooden handle. It is lovely fan. Next. This is made of grass. This is also from the collection of IGRMS. This is also, this area, they beautifully prepared by paper and with the help of colored thread. And this is the grass. This is grass and wooden handle they have. Now, folded fans. These are called folded fans, sandalwood folded fans made by Krishnavi Ravalaya, Kanhara, Mumbai, Bombay, from Bombay Presidents. It was purchased in 1886 for rupees 20. You can see the trellis work of the each leaves. And when anybody take fanning herself, any lady, this is especially used for the ladies, aristocrat ladies, and it gives sandalwood wood fumes. This fan presented by Maharaja, His Holiness Maharaja Holkar from Indore in 1884. This is also made of sandalwood, and this is perforated designs, and the handle made of sandalwood, which is a peacock. It's a beautiful fan. Presented to Indian Museum in 1884. Next, this is ivory fan from gifted by Monilal Nahar Bahadur, Rai Monilal Nahar Bahadur collection. They have given, he has given lots of collection to Indian Museum in 1928, and we have received this intricately designed ivory fan, folded ivory fan, beautiful. Next, this is also from Khulna, Bangladesh. It is acquired by from Maghia Khulna, presented to Indian Museum. It is this area they have put a cloth, fine cloth to attach, and it easily can fold it also. And see this area, there is design like a Chinese trellis work. It's a beautiful trellis work. Next, it's a lovely fan, hand fan. This fan purchased from Babu Sri Kishan Das, Kuna, Kolkata, for rupees 300. You can find the intricately carved ivory trellis work. It's a fine fan. That's all. Now we can say that who are the users and how beautifully they have prepared this fan. And we know it was first Portuguese trader brought fans from China and Japan in 16th century, and it became popular in Pan-Asia. When we find the portrait of or any picture of Elizabeth I, we can see the fan. She is holding a fan because it was become a fashion and it's become a part of a dress or in European countries and Japan also. We can we know that they use fan as a part of their dress, and for India it was popular due to highly humidity and heat, to get rid of heat and from humidity, sweat, they use these fans, and they become so fashionable, and we now museums, we are keeping them as a our heritage, that these fans gives an idea the young generation and future generation the how this period use these hand fans most as a part of their life. Thank you. Any question?
Many questions and some queries, and you know, first of all, I must congratulate you for this very, very insightful, meaningful, very, you know, revealing. It is a very revealing kind of a very informative lecture that you have presented here in front of us. You know, this is the beauty. I always say this is the beauty of folk culture of India, because in every utilitarian item you can see the sense of beauty, sense of aesthetics. You know, you have talked about a face, you have talked about the face which is used, which is made of, you know, elephant tusk and elephant, you know, bows. You have talked about the wood fan, we have talked about the fan which is made of sandalwood, we are talking about the you know, the perforated designs. You have talked about the fans which have been collected from the tribal area, fans which are made of bronze, and fans which are you know, bordered with cloths and multiple designs, hand fans which contain, you know, what you say, the portraits of the people, the kings and the royals, of the gods and the goddesses. You have talked about Krishna and all those things. Also about Durga, Kali, you know, that situations. So you see how the people of Bengal are called those humid area where it is in fashion, and palm is the common thing we all have used, you know, palm in our early childhood. I wanted to know, has somebody from Calcutta or anywhere else in Eastern India his and her PhD on the collection of fans, hand
fans? Please repeat. I can't hear.
Has somebody took it, the collection of your face and hand face as his and her PhD work?
Collection of?
No. PhD work.
Nobody has given.
No.
I have prepared in one local publisher told me that you prepare a write up on hand fan. We will publish. I have prepared, and nobody
last I'm working from last 29 years in Indian Museum. Nobody come to work on hand fan. Nobody is interested, because hand fan is still using in the village area. Still, because load shedding is more, when current is not available, they used hand fan. Each and every family, they have hand fan. I would like to share one thing. बचपन में ऐसा कोई नहीं है बंगाल में जो उसकी माँ का वो पांक ये हैंड फैन के डांट से मार नहीं खाया होगा. गुस्से हो जाते थे मदर और मदर डिपेंड विद हैंड फैन. ऐसा कोई नहीं है बच्चे. तो दिस इज
गुड 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 गुड. अच्छा आप बताइए मुझे व्हाट इज द टोटल स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ हैंड फैन. यू नो द नंबर
व्हाइट टैल्क नॉट ब्लैक. वी डोंट हैव ब्लैक टैल्क.
व्हाट इज द टोटल नंबर ऑफ हैंड. आई वांटेड टू नो द टोटल नंबर ऑफ हैंड फैंस देयर इन योर कस्टडी.
25
we
have.
Okay, you know, I know one artist who is well known in India, Jatin Das.
Yes, I know. And once Jatin Das, his book, his catalog, I have seen.
I work with him, you know. And for all the viewers, I want to say
he has that Jatin, I have seen.
Yeah, his catalog. I just give it to you. You know, Jatin Das has a huge collection of 1100 hand fans with him, and that was his first collection. And he was very, very, you know, he was madly attached with his hand fans. He was not touched there and all those things. And you know, he told me, Kailash, you can do this. I said, but look, I am an anthropologist. I am not a man of, you know, conservation, preservation, and all those things. So let the people who have done their specialization in conservation handle this. And, you know, he was very whimsical about it. And finally, IGNCA people did not allow him to do this. And then he went some other place. And finally, somehow he could manage to exhibit his, you know, wonderful collection. I must tell you that his collection of 1100 fans, hand fans, is a master collection. Master collection. Okay. I had been to your museum many a times, but I could not have opportunity to go and see your hand fans. Now I will go once upon a time. My boss was in charge of your Yeah. Rajiv Bhattacharya told me if you can work on this, but you know, unfortunately, we did not work. But anyway, I have a very, very senior, interesting, and qualified viewer, Nandan Shastri. Nandan Shastri probably knows you. He says, Neeta ji, very interesting topic chosen by you. As a geologist, the top fan seems to me a unique one. It is white mica, which is muscovite. Yes. If there is a black talk, it is biotech.
We don't have
black to him. You don't have black one. So, sir, I think you have got the answer. And thank you, the senior geologist, sir. And your remark is a valuable remark for us. You know, I tell you, in our folklore, there is a tradition of, you know, using hand fan to, you know, give proper respect to the guests who are coming to you. And there are so many folk songs, ritual songs, which contains the beauty of fans, the way it is used, and that also signifies the power of the guest. You know, the damad, wo bahut bada guest hota hai. And sandhi, you know, they are the biggest guest. And how the fans are being run, rotate, manage. So there is an entire cognitive system of exploring the use of fans through the world, through the metaphors, in the narratives, in the songs, in the rituals, pens are there. You know, in Maithili, pens is called BN. BN probably it is, you know, it is rotated like this. So
another one is this one.
Okay. So it's a very good thing, but you know, it's a very rare thing that such a huge collection of pens are there in your life, in your museum, Indian Museum, which is probably
Independence collection, because at that time there was no other museum. Indian Museum is the mother of all museum in Tunisia.
Agreed. There is no denial of your
statement. Independence collection. Later on, National Museum come up and other museums.
National Museum is a baby of, you know, Indian Museum. Yes. When instrumental
National Museum. Yeah. My director, who has given me permission to deliver this lecture with the help of our Indian Museum collection, Dr. Eddie Chowdhury. He has encouraged me a lot to deliver this lecture. Thank you, sir, and thank you all of you, and especially Misra ji. Thank you. Without your encouragement, to deliver this lecture.
Please convey our regards also to Professor K.D. Chowdhury, and tell that the folkmen is really, really very happy to know that you have very gracefully permitted you to come and deliver this lecture. And this lecture, you know, this world is a cyber world where the knowledge is available. This is a grooming and zooming of the knowledge. Knowledge should not be restricted to one museum and one particular area. It is nice as he has understood the power of democracy, which is practiced in the website, in this, you know, cyber world. So please convey our thanks, gratitude to there is a festival, ritual festival in Mithila and other part of India, Nepal also. This is called Bat Savitri, where the Bat Briksha is being worshipped. And the Bat Savitri, there is a ritual to use, you know, newly bought hand fans. So viewers are saying this. We have Dr. Geeta Malhotra. She says that Japan also uses small fans, but traditionally India has these fans, and in some villages these are still made. Yes, she is confirming your statement. Not only Japan, ma'am, China has also been using fans. And you know, in colonial India, you know, fans were at all a new thing for the Britishers, because in Britain they could not even imagine to have the fans, that too the hand fans. So when they came to India, they saw the humidity, because they established their culture, their capital, you know, administrative in Calcutta. So they have to face the humidity of Calcutta. So, you know, this was a very natural thing, and then they started collecting it in the National Museum. So it came as gift, it came as they bought it, and wherever they went, they collected from the persons also. And there are many imported, you know, fans also. So that is probably the answer, right? And we have शांति स्वरूप सिन्हा.
यस,
वो आपकी बहुत प्रशंसा कर रहे हैं. वो कह रहे हैं शोध परक और ज्ञान वर्धक व्याख्यान बधाई. यू नो, वी आर रियली वेरी हैप्पी टू हैव यू. सो एज अ मैटर ऑफ फैक्ट, एवरीबॉडी इज वेरी हैप्पी टू सी यू, टू सी योर प्रेजेंटेशन, टू नो द डीपर डिटेल्स ऑफ हैंड फैंस. अदरवाइज वी ऑल हैव सीन फैंस, hand fans in our early childhood. We have used them, and we are still using it when we are in the remote areas. You know, tribals are using fans according to their own facility. Am I now audible?
I can't hear.
Okay, wait for a minute.
I can't hear.
Okay. I will come. Am I audible now?
It is not audible. It is not audible. It is not audible.
Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now? So it was a wonderful
game.
It was a wonderful presentation. Thank you very much.
I can't hear you. না আপনি লাইভ আছেন কিন্তু এখন কিছু বলবেন না আমি একটু চেয়ারে বসলাম তো মাটিতে বসে থেকে ভালো বলছে
Thank you. I'm sorry again. There was some, problem in the voice modulation. Thank you very much for your presentation. You came and you delivered a very insightful lecture. And we are really, really thankful. Okay.
I can't hear you. It's not audible for me.
It was a good presentation. It was a good presentation. We are really, really very, very thankful to you. Thank you. Thank you. Bye bye.